Everyone. Welcome to our tutorial series on how to use the PC UI control for our BDM and BRU series amplifiers. We understand that some customers may not be familiar with this feature, so we'll create a series of videos to introduce the different functions of the PC UI, such as bass enhancement, EQ, and dynamic range compressor. In this first video, we'll cover the basic operations of the PC UI, including how to connect your amplifier and how to save your configurations. In this video, we'll use the BRU5 amplifier and ACP Workbench software for demonstration. If you're interested in obtaining this software, please contact our customer service team on AliExpress. It's worth noting that the BDM3, BDM9, and BRU5 all utilize the same BP1048B2 Bluetooth and DSP chip, which means that the operations are the same across these products. First, let's get it connected. As you can see, the BRU5 amplifier comes equipped with a USB port that allows you to connect it to your PC. Once connected, the software will automatically read the configuration parameters and refresh the interface. If the software successfully recognizes the BRU5, you will see the parameters displayed on the interface. However, if the interface appears gray and no data is shown, it means that the connection has failed. In this case, please try repowering the device and reconnecting it to your PC. One of the great features of this software is its hot plug capability. This means that you can disconnect and reconnect the device at any time during operation, and the software will recognize it successfully. Now, we're on the audio module page, where you'll find the basic audio configurations. We can leave these settings as they are and move on to the audio effect page for further adjustments. This software offers a wide range of function lists, including list 0 for microphone, list 2 for guitar amplifier, and list 3 for recorded audio. Typically, we'll use list 1 for our purposes. For now, we'll use the Music Pre-EQ function to make a simple EQ adjustment. This will allow us to demonstrate how to save configurations. In a later video, we'll provide a more detailed introduction to this feature. As you can see, F0 and F1 have already been used, so we don't recommend adjusting F0 and F1, as these frequency points are already occupied by internal resources and adjusting them may cause the parameters to not be saved properly. We can add other frequency points for adjustment. In our next video, we'll introduce bass enhancement and provide demonstrations. So, stay tuned. If you found this video helpful, please like, share, or comment, and consider subscribing to our channel. Thank you.